Hello, callers, and welcome back to Viva Barça, the home of everything Barça. In this episode, I'm going to be bringing you guys the very latest on FC Barcelona as usual. We are going to be discussing on two stories. We are going to start with this report from ESPN that is claiming that Barcelona are eyeing two Chelsea forwards as alternative for Raheem Sterling. You know, recently Manchester City have been stressing on the fact that if Barça want to go for Sterling on a loan this January, Barcelona must make that purchase option obligatory, and Barca don't really want that. And so Barca are looking elsewhere for alternative. If that doesn't work out, you know, if Raheem Sterling's own doesn't work out, Barca are eyeing Timo Werner and Hakim Ziyech. This is not the first time I've been talking about these players linked to FC Barcelona, but Barca will take them seriously if Sterling's operation do not work out. We are going to be discussing on that as we progress. Then secondly, we are going to be talking about Liverpool midfielder and former Barcelona player Thiago Alcantara, a player that have been linked with a return to the Camp Nou recently. Alcantara have just responded to those reports saying that he does not see himself leaving Liverpool anytime soon. He wants to be focused, and of course he's enjoying his life at Liverpool at the moment. We are going to be discussing on that as well. So guys, as we get ready to discuss those stories in much detail, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. If you haven't subscribed, give this video a like and make sure to watch this video right up to the very end. Barcelona's pursuit of Manchester City attacker Raheem Sterling is no secret at this point. Barca had been hot in his trails in the summer, but a move never materialized. Since Xavi took over the reins, you know, they have once again become aggressive in chasing Raheem Sterling ahead of the January transfer window. However, a move to land the ex-Liverpool star looks very, very difficult at the moment. It is claimed that Barcelona, bound by their financial problems, are only looking at players who they can sign on loan in the winter. In addition, they wish to include an option to make the transfer permanent at the end of the season and not an obligation to do so. But Manchester City, of course, are stressing that if Barca takes Sterling on loan, they make it obligatory to sign him on permanently, making the deal complicated. As a result, they have now switched their attention towards Chelsea duo Hakim Ziyech and Timo Werner, according to ESPN. Barcelona are mainly targeting players that, you know, are not regulars for their current teams, which very much holds true for both Ziyech and Werner at Chelsea. The former signed for 40 million euros from Ajax last year. I'm talking about Ziyech. You know, he has been bogged down by injury issues at the Stamford Bridge, while his game time under Thomas Tuchel has not been significant. Indeed, this term Ziyech is, you know, has started just two Premier League games. Meanwhile, Werner, who signed on from RB Leipzig in a 53 million euros deal, I think, has failed to establish himself in the West London club as well. So the German international's profligacy in front of goal prompted Chelsea to go big on Romelu Lukaku this summer, leaving him behind in the pecking order. Barcelona intend on bolstering their attacking unit in January, with Xavi especially keen on reinforcing his wide areas. Ziyech, while not necessarily a traditional winger, you know, would add a lot of value to the team with his vision and ability to create chances. As for Werner, his, you know, searing pace and ability to you know, play anywhere across the front line could make him an asset to the Camp Nou. Any move for the pair, however, would depend on Barcelona's ability to offload some of their current players. The Catalans are in no position to register new players in January after the hiring of Xavi and his staff and the resigning of Dani Alves, something that director Matteo Alemany has confirmed. So Barcelona will first need to shed some load off their wage bill in order to make this happen, you know, to make room for any new signings in January, be it Ziyech, Werner, or primary target Sterling himself. Then on to the next story of discussion. Thiago Alcantara has endured a torrid time with his fitness since swapping Bayern Munich for Liverpool just over a year ago, with a knee injury ruling him out of action for several months, and of course hampering his progress last season. Jurgen Klopp has been patient with Thiago's recovery though, and the midfielder has shown glimpses of the undoubted quality he has, of course making 8 appearances in all competitions for the Reds so far this season. However, there have been persistent rumors linking Thiago with a return to Barcelona throughout his stay on Merseyside, 8 years after the Spain international left his boyhood club. Xavi, taking charge of the Catalan Giants, has only intensified talk of possible reunion with the newly appointed Barca boss, reportedly asking the club to bring the former teammate back to the Camp Nou. Pressed on the speculation linking him with Barca ahead of Liverpool's Champions League clash with Porto, Thiago told reporters, "As always, I have been, you know, a guy who plays football and I am not concerned about the rumors or whatever. I'm focused on the duty that I have with my team, the years that I have under contract with my team, and I just want to know about this new adventure that I have here in the Premier League. I'm trying to win all the trophies I can, and my compromise is maximum with this team." Thiago shone in Liverpool's comprehensive 4-0 victory over Arsenal in the weekend, and of course the Spaniard is keen to contribute as much as possible over the coming weeks and months to, you know, banish the memory of such a frustrating debut season. So colors, with that we come to an end of this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you did enjoy the video and also hope you did subscribe. If you haven't, please make sure to subscribe so you always stay up to date with the latest on FC Barcelona here on Viva Barça. Until next time, bye bye.